Tonight's video, guys, we are going to be playing a solos zombie game on the new Firebase Z. Now, usually, I'd be playing with either friends or subscribers or followers on Twitch or YouTube, but before we do any of that, before I start playing with any other people, I would like to try it out for myself on solos. Now, I was kind of getting confused as to why it wasn't starting, but you know, we're starting off now. So in tonight's video, guys, I'm just going to be going over the basics of the game, where to find all the perks, where to find, you know, pack a punch, how to start up pack a punch, because it's not like the first one, and just being able to understand where to go, what to do, and what the whole idea of it is. Now, I will be probably going only until level 15, because that will probably lead us all the way up to around half an hour mark. But if you guys do want me to make a video that is over an hour long, to like around 50, maybe even a bit more, but please let me know what you guys want to see, and I will try and make that happen. But for the time being, before we do anything else, I just want to make sure that I'm actually getting out some content on the zombies game, first and foremost. So, we are obviously in Vietnam, that is the idea of it, so Pack-a-Punch is obviously here before you go into this. Now, for those of you who are wondering where Quick Revive is, it is the first thing that you see, which is literally there. Right in the open at the spawn point. We're just gonna get some money together. Now, if you want in like chopper gun and things like that, there's a crafting table here right by Pack-a-Punch. So that's another good thing to keep an eye out for, because you're definitely gonna need sentry gun, chopper gunner, things like that. So it's definitely gonna be very useful. Now, when you're looking to go to the teleporter, this is the door to open. That's why the arrows there. Now, you don't really spy at first because you're not really looking for arrows, but luckily they have labeled it to make it a little bit more clearer for those that don't know where to look. Now, usually, you know, you're going to be looking around thinking, why are these doors locked? It's because you haven't turned on the power. So what you'll have to do is turn on the generators, which you'll see in a moment. Now, obviously, the difficulty has increased dramatically, which is kind of annoying, but at the same time, I tell you what, we're going to get a shotgun as well. Might as well get a shotgun. Okay, we haven't even got enough for a shotgun right now, so see if we can do up a barrier, maybe. Okay, we have enough for a shotgun now, so we're going to go over, pick up the shotgun off the wall, just so that we've got something to use. Now, the teleporter is always going to be here. It's never going to change, never going to be any different. So just remember that. Now, you're in the main area where you've got to turn on all the generators for the power. Now, you've got Tombstone, which is a new perk that has been added to the game, which allows you to actually revive yourself if you go down. Now, you probably will go down, and it's a good idea to have that, to get a second chance on doing things. Now, this does get a bit confusing with, you know, where the instructions are trying to tell you where to go, but don't be fooled and don't be confused, because if it's saying I'll go straight over, it's literally all you gotta do, guys, is go through this gate and go through there. Now, this shotgun needs to be upgraded. It's not the best, but we'll definitely use that, because we're definitely gonna need that to go into the next part. So, and it's always gonna go in order. So it's always gonna start with this one. So the first thing you need to do is have 500 pounds or 500 credit, whatever it is, and it's always 500 for each. So what you're gonna do once you do that is you've got three different things over here that you need to protect, which is one, two, which is over there, and another one right here. Now, for those of you that don't know, Juggernog is in the first area that you look, because it will be one of the big things that you'll need to get, because getting shields on this map is a little bit different and it's a lot harder in my opinion. So now we've got enough, what we're going to do is just set it up now. For those of you guys that are probably wondering, how does this actually get any charge? Well, this is charged up by actually sucking in the zombie's souls. So if you guys remember back to when Black Ops 2, I think, where it's called Trenches or something like that, and you actually have to keep an eye on all the bits, because the damage is going up at the same time. All the zombie souls, as you can see now, it's been powered up through all the zombie souls, and that happened in the World War, I think it was called, what was it called? I'm just trying to think of what it was called, but it was like in the trenches, and you had, you had to literally open up certain generators and kill certain zombies until their souls have been gone in, and you had them in Easter eggs as well. So obviously we can't access that one just yet, or access going through there. That's a different shortcut, but you have to go through the main gates, which are located here and here. Now I don't know if there's two or if there's three or four. I think it's only three for now. So what we're gonna do is actually go through here. We have to unlock that once we've got a little bit more money. Interesting. It's actually a pretty good spot to keep zombies away. Now that's the next one. So we're gonna go on from here, and we're literally just gonna turn on the generator once we have got the zombies coming in. Because once the zombies come in, it's gonna be a bloodbath. So this one's gonna be a little bit more difficult, guys, because you know you can deal with these sort of things. So now we got one down here, one here. Stairs is being attacked, but hopefully we can get to it in time. Right, we've got it, we've done it. That's completely fine. So now we've got another one. Just need to do the third one now. And you've got these little jump pads as well, but you need to do them until all of them have been linked up. So the final one, I think it is only three. Thank God. Usually on Call of Duty Zombies, they always say that you gotta do four generators instead of three. But luckily in this one, they've only given you three tasks, and it's quite a lot to do with generators. I try to do each different generator. Oh, okay. So to get to the next place, guys, we need to go to. nicely. We need a lot more zombies, so we're just going to turn on the reactor. Once we do this, I will then do like a sort of guide of where all the pack-a-punch things are, all the shields, and not only that, I will then show you where to get shields, where to get all the other perks. Okay, cool. We haven't got much to do now, which is fine. Ammo. I think the biggest thing for us is actually trying to find ammo crates, because it does become a bit more of a rarity trying to figure out where. Oh, here we go. Ideal. Oh wow, that's savage. Much else apart from those. Now, not only is there aliens that with the tentacles and things like that, there is also I think it's like a warden looking super soldier. Now, if we go back to the teleport, this is another place where you can get shields. There is, I think, 3 to 4 places to actually get shields, which is actually amazing. Really helpful. Now, I do forget, usually that where you go to get shields is where you can upgrade your weapons, like from a common to a rare to a legendary, so. We will have to do that at some point. But I think the first thing we'll have to do is actually pack a bunch of this weapon. Right, so we'll go through it now. Say this is round 8. And we've got shields already, so now look, you'll see pack a punch switch on. Now there's also the idea of actually picking whatever perk you want from here, which is ideal. Then you've also another one here, so that's incredibly useful. But once we've got enough, we'll definitely upgrade it again, and we'll have to change obviously the rarity of the shotgun. Find some intel. There is one intel bit here. Well, okay, it's gone. That's interesting. Now, I'm gonna get this because it's a pretty decent gun. It's a high rarity, and we can pack a bunch of that early on, and it actually might be a bit more useful than the shotgun down the road. So we're on level 9. Now I'm going to take you through where all the other perks are going to be, and what you'll probably have to do down the road. So obviously, Tombstone, as you saw earlier, guys. Juggernog is through here. So we're going to go through this door. Now it's all the way down the bottom. Down there. So that's where you're going to find Juggers. Probably just use this. More useful, to be honest. Okay, so we've got Jug, we've got Tombstone, and now you obviously know where Crow 5 is. red shield, so if you want to upgrade your weapon, you can definitely do that. So now we're on to blue. That's a rare weapon, which is ideal, and this is where you actually get the blueprint for the weapon. Now you just gotta find the actual parts, as you can see. That is for the weapon. But I don't know exactly know where the weapon is, so we're gonna go for a little look around for that later on. That'll be another video to find all the parts. Ideal, thank God. Now, if we go upstairs, we'll find another perk. So, I think it's around here. There we are, quick revive, quick reload. Which is right here, which is ideal. It's definitely going to be a lifesaver for us. But like I said, doing up the rarities on the guns definitely does improve a lot on the weapons. Not only that, it can be very useful to pack a bunch a lot easier, and it's always something. So we're gonna go for a little look around. That looks like the actual wonder weapon then. It's kind of interesting. Collect intel, nice. So even that, it's not even pack a bunch, it's still taking some serious damage. Just gotta look at these sort of like tables and see what else you can find. But once I start looking around the map, which I'll do at a different point, I will then be able to show you exactly where. Now, here's another place to get armor. So as you can see on the shield up on the map, if you look at those, you'll find out where the armor is, as well as all the perks. So that's gonna be very useful. I don't know what's that. Okay, interesting. Just getting sucked in like that's not exactly pleasant. Speed cola. I think it's upstairs. Now speed cola is definitely going to be useful, especially in these situations, getting away from other creatures. So we're definitely going to use that. Now I do not exactly know where the other ones are. We'll have a little look around, shall we? So that actually gives you like airstrikes and things like that, so we're going to use this jump pad here. Oh wait, that's the landing point. Have a look around. Like I said guys, it's a massive map, there's so much going on, so many things to do, and if you guys get stuck looking for any of the random boxes and things like that, you can literally find it from the light or on the map itself. Just gotta look around in these weird areas. because you never know what you're going to find. Collect intel. Okay. Now, obviously, this is where you do your challenges. Collect more intel. Stuck. That's my head in. So this is what you also got to deal with, guys, on round 15. Is that you got to deal with an assault wave, which is like a massive wave of zombies. So it's going to be quite challenging. Obviously, if you've got the right things for it, then it does help. But if you don't, good luck. Okay, it's on this side, which is fine. Sentry guns. Jesus, that's intense. And the waves get incredible. Interesting. This is mental. Open spot. Okay, we've got 12, that's it, it's fine. Four more. Easy. Nice. But yeah, guys, next video will be on literally building the Wonder Weapon. So if you guys want to see that video, let me know in the comment section what you guys want in the next zombie video.